completely looted, and we are seeing this up and down Madison Avenue in the middle of Manhattan. We know that the mayor is driving around New York City. He said he stopped at Barclays Center in Brooklyn and said the protests were peaceful and fine. And realized that it was not based on his Twitter account, and it clearly has not been. This is still a dangerous situation. I will say that if you look over here down Madison, it's empty. So they blocked off Madison Avenue, and now you're starting to see the effects of that curfew. But we are hearing lots of reports of people just shifting. What's happening now, Shannon, is that people, they steal their stuff, they jump into vehicles and they move to the next spot. It's a coordinated thing. We've seen license plates from Texas out here, and I know that the NYPD has said that they believe at least one out of the seven that were arrested so far before tonight were people from out of state, as far as Nevada and Texas, but also from, you know, New Jersey and Connecticut, people from all over who have come into our city and have decided to take full advantage of the situation and destroy it. And that's what's happened tonight, and it's continuing to happen. It seems like the situation, at least in this area, is now under control, but we are hearing about looters downtown and also now on the west side. Again, all day they have been moving around the city, taking advantage of the situation. We were at the Macy's. We obviously had video of people stealing even before 8 p.m. tonight, which is where the new curfew will be tomorrow. We saw an officer that was down, injured during this. He seemed to be okay, but we are seeing videos of an officer in the Bronx reportedly attacked as well tonight. Mass looting on a grand scale here in New York City, and it's tremendously sad to see. It's not just the looting; it's the fact that this is trashing the city that we love, in a city that, frankly, has gone through so much over the last 3 months. So many people have been waiting to come out of their apartments and out of their homes to enjoy this city, and they haven't been able to because of coronavirus, and now it's being destroyed while they're stuck in their apartments. So, Shannon, that's the situation here.
Yeah, Brian, it's an incredible 1-2 punch because the city, as you said, has had so much pain over the last few months. And was just getting the inkling of, within weeks, being able to return back out to work that people so desperately need to a city they love very much. Please stay safe. Brian, we'll check back with you. Thank you for your reporting there on the ground. Continue through the weekend and tonight. We'll also